As we close the book on another fantastic console generation, it's only natural to look back at some of its defining games. A lot of them come as a general consensus. The impeccable open world of Red Dead Redemption 2, the dramatic evolution of God of War, the gorgeous discipline of Bloodborne, and the boundless wonder of Outer Wilds. But for my money, there's one single game that stands out as the most underrated game of this generation. Before releasing Spider-Man on the PS4 and officially sealing the deal with Sony and becoming a first-party studio, Insomniac Games was in business with Microsoft. And through that partnership, we got 2014's Sunset Overdrive, which was, and still remains, the Xbox One's best exclusive. But sadly, it seems to be one of those games that got lost amidst the chaos of the generation. At first glance, it has everything you'd expect from an open-world action game from the minds at Insomniac. Sunset City pops with vibrant colors and a strong sense of style, like an amalgam of Miami, Tokyo, and a Saturday morning cartoon. There's a massive array of strange weapons at your disposal as you battle endless hordes of mutants hopped up on a toxic energy drink. Like the Ratchet & Clank series, you're encouraged to experiment with your strange arsenal, as they grow and evolve the more you use them. Acid sprinklers in the shape of corporate mascots, explosive teddy bears, and a Roman candle Gatling gun are just a few of the toys you'll have at your fingertips. And then there's the fire-from-the-hip approach to humor and pop culture references that had me genuinely laughing at the game's writing and scenarios in that classic Insomniac way.
I met other survivors like you.
That dead body over there? That one of them? Hey, dead guy.
These elements are all great in their own right, but ultimately congealed together impeccably well. But the magic of Sunset Overdrive and the thing that vaults it into such rarefied atmospheres is in just how it feels to play the game. I'll be the first to admit, there's a bit of a steep learning curve here. You have to rewire your brain and forget a lot of what other open-world games have taught us for decades. But once you start to understand just what it is that Insomniac's going for, Sunset transforms into a singular experience. When you're on the ground, your maximum speed is just north of a brisk jog, which isn't great when there's an apocalypse going on around you. But what Insomniac teaches you pretty early on in the game is that if your feet are touching the ground, you're probably doing it wrong. That's because Sunset City is designed to be traversed less like Grand Theft Auto and more like Tony Hawk or Jet Set Radio. Most open-world games are filled with pockets of fun separated by stretches of low-key travel. Drive across a city to start a mission, climb up a tower to unlock some more of the map, ride your horse to an interesting spot on the horizon. But what Sunset Overdrive accomplishes so well is in making the journey from A to B every bit as entertaining as the destinations themselves. You'll quickly start to see the world around you not as a series of streets and buildings, but as a playground for you to jam across in the most stylish way possible. Power lines are there for grinding, cars become makeshift trampolines, and even the walls themselves are simply surfaces to ride across. Your own momentum becomes your best friend as you quickly process the landscape around you and figure out the best way to get to where you're going without slowing down. The expression you put into your movement also feeds into the game's excellent combat encounters. While something like Gears of War feels immensely heavy as you slam up against the wall and use it for momentary cover, Sunset Overdrive makes you feel as light as a feather. Juggling between where all of your enemies are, which weapons are most effective for which scenarios, and the best routes to stay in firing range while still keeping up your momentum is a lesson in multitasking. Like I said, it takes a bit to fully grasp onto this concept, but once you have it, the game becomes a ballet of destruction unlike anything else. I understand why Sunset Overdrive isn't talked about as much as it should be. In a generation largely defined by major single-player games that could be played on PlayStation 4, having Sunset never make its way to Sony's shores kept it out of a lot of conversations. And that's a genuine shame, because the game feels like a singular and unique experience that stands out from every single one of its peers. Thankfully, the strong sense of style and unique mechanics have allowed it to age gracefully. It looks and plays every bit as good today as it did back in 2014. And with its inclusion on Xbox Game Pass and the backwards compatibility of the Xbox Series X, here's to hoping that this new generation ushers in a brand new flock of players to experience the most underrated game of the previous one.